الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا مولانا محمد رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهداه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على حبيبك الأعظم سيدنا مولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا مولانا رب العالمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد المخصوص بالمعراج الأكبر في المدة الخارقة الأقصر، فوطئ بأخمصيه كثبان مسك قيعان الجنان الأثفر، وشرب بيده الشريفة من الكوثر، وواجه وجهك الكريم وجهه الأزهر، وأريته بقصره ذاتك الأفخر، وخاطبته بكلامك الأزلي المقدس الأطهر، فهو حبيبك وعين مرادك وخليلك وفيض ودادك ورحمتك المهداة لعبادك. اللهم صل عليه بصلاتك التي صليت عليه يوم خلقته وأوجدته، وبصلاتك التي صليت عليه بها يوم بعثته وأرسلته، وبصلاتك التي صليت عليه بها يوم أنيته ليلة المعراج وناجيته، صلاة تجعلنا بها ووالدينا وأهلينا المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات من ساكني قلبه والفائزين في الدارين بقربه وحبه، آمين يا رب العالمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. My beloved brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, we are together live in this program in a remembrance of a very blessed night, the night which is, we can call it the night of night, the night of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, the night of the travel at night from Mecca to Jerusalem, which is, we call it Al-Isra, well, Al-Isra, and then the night which is from the world, from Jerusalem to the seventh heavens. This miracle of Isra al-Mi'raj is extraordinary. In fact, it's an extraordinary night in the life of our beloved Master Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it's also for the Ummah, in the heart of the Ummah. Because the night of Isra wal-Mi'raj shows Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shows him the reality of himself. Who is he? Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him from Masjid al-Haram, subhanahu alladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-Masjid al-Haram, which means exalted is he who took his servant by the night from al-Masjid al-Haram. Al-Masjid al-Haram at that time was just Kaaba, and it was not a masjid. It's not a place for sujood and for the Muslims to pray. But looks like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, This place going to be a masjid, a holy mosque. This is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he gave him an extra gift also. So if subhanahu exalted is he who took his servant by the night from the al-masjid al-haram to al-masjid al-aqsa, to Jerusalem. And that place also going to be masjid. So it's a hope, and also confirming the hope. And in fact, it's giving him a gift which he never thought, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam, my beloved brothers and sisters, he was passing a very hard time. Because his father, his uncle, Abu Talib, who was looking after him outside his house, the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by defending him from the people and the non-believers of Mecca, passed away. Passed away in an embargo which took more than 2 years, where the Muslims kept in one place and they did a sanction against them for 2 years, where there's no food coming in or nothing else except that smuggled to them. And his wife also passed away in the same time. the time where that wife passed away, whom she was giving him the hope and the courage inside his house, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that clearly called Amul Huzn, the year of sadness, because he had lost two of his beloveds, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And furthermore, he went to Taif, where the people reject him, and they have sent the kids and wild people to throw him with the stones, till his face was bleeding, his hands bleeding, and his both blessed feet were bleeding. And then he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him support, and he said, as long as you, Allah, you are with me, I don't care for anything else. As long as you are pleased with me, I don't care for anything else. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him in this journey to show him the reality of Muhammad to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The people of earth were very rude, but now we see the behavior and the reception of the people of heaven, whom are the angels. He was passing one heaven after one heaven, and he was welcomed by the angels of Allah and by the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have sent to all mankind. And all of these prophets were greeting him, welcoming him, and praising him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is really shows who is Muhammad alayhi salatu salam for angels, for the messengers, and for all mankind after that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have chosen Isra al-Mi'raj to be happen, not because of Rasulullah wanted. Maybe he never thought of it, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave an extraordinary gifts and support always for the people need for help and support, like what he did to all his prophets and messengers, and what he did to Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. After what he have seen and all the welcome and greeting he have seen and he have experienced, of course, there will be nothing in the world worth to think of it. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you, there will be nothing, no one can be against you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this miracle of, which is miracle, when we say miracle, it's witnessed only by him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It never witnessed by others. By why the condition of a miracle, mu'jizat, is that an extraordinary thing happen, and to Allah give it to prophets and messengers, and witnessed by their people, so that they will enter to iman, or the iman to be strengthened, and in support from Allah to that prophet or messenger. But al-Isra al-Mi'raj is only been seen by Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so it is for him. And to him, you say, this is your position, and this is who you are, and this is what I have given you. Subhanalladhi asra, exalted glory to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, from beginning. الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى, who took his servant in a night journey. This is me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is me, no one else. I want to show my servant. When he called him servant, this is a very high ranking, my brothers and sisters. Don't care for titles which are given to you by people, like when you call the scholars or other people. But care for your important title, which is your link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is servant. Allah's servant subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more you show servitude to him, the more you're close to him, and that shows you're obedient to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only by name, but it's also by action. Sayyidina al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wassalam was amazed with the trip. But he amazed more with the reception and with the welcoming, and he was amazed with the gift which been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the ummah through Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
we are unable to get this thing. No one can get to go in a night journey or to Mi'raj in one night. This happened only for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But we are given a gift that it can take our spirits to experience closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter where you are, and no matter from where we came, but it's need from us humbleness of the heart. This gift is the five time prayers. It's the only obligatory which was given to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in an extraordinary place in heaven, not through Jibreel. It was given directly from Allah to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So this is a very special gift, my beloved brothers and sisters, which we really need to think of it. Are we looking after this gift, five time prayers? There are conditions, shurut, arkan, sunan, and wajibat for prayers, you know. But do we know the meaning of prayers in the first place? What is a prayer? The prayer, you see, when you take wuzu, you need wuzu. Condition for prayers is you have for you to have wudu, first of all, ablution. But is this ablution is enough to clean your body to pray? How about your heart? The night journey, when it's happened, the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was filled and amazed with what heart have seen. ما كذب الفؤاد ما رأى. The heart lies not what he have seen. Now you have to experience to see an extraordinary gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through your prayers, five time prayers, through your nafila, through your tahajjud time. If you are gifted, you'll have the blessings of having tahajjud time alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night, like the journey of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was at night. So you have to experience that, my beloved brothers and sisters. And we can see the blessing and the prayers in yourself through your action. Inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar. So prayers will keep you away from all false talks and false doing. If we are just praying five times, but our akhlaq, our attitude, our etiquette, our moral character, useless, na'udhu billah, then these prayers won't give us anything. It won't make you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my beloved brothers and sisters. Our salat is very fast. And sometimes we pray just before the time over, because he doesn't know the meaning of it. We think it's just obligatory, I have to pray it and that's it. Because of, if not, there'll be a punish. Don't think in this way. Why not you pray on time with full of khushu' because you want the reward of it? Why always think of punish? And why you think it's just something I have to do and become like عَادَّ وَلَيْسَتْ عِبَادَةً, become like tradition, not religion? Why we do that? Because we doesn't understand from where the prayers came. Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam have seen an angels in heaven. These angels, from the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them, they were in a position of qiyam, standing, position of ruku', bowing, or position of sujood, prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either one position, they have no opportunity of having these three positions in one, but we have it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this opportunity to pray in qiyam, ruku' and sujood. Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, furthermore, he came with that blessed meeting and gathering and celebration. He came with humbleness to put his forehead in the ground with humbleness. If Allah giving you anything, you have to be more humble. Don't think your money will make you an extraordinary person. Don't think of your knowledge will make you an extraordinary person. Don't think your position will make you an extraordinary person. Your humbleness and support to the people and your help to them will make you extraordinary person. When you spend your money in a right way, when you look after your position in a purest way, and when you present your people in a best way. Therefore, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was more humble after this gift of Al-Isra al-Mi'raj, which all of us to remember always. Al-Habib al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, جُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. Allah have made the cool of my eyes through the prayers. جُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. Prayers. Let us imagine that I'm praying in Medina during the time of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and around me all Sahaba and Ahl Bayti Rasulullah. When I turn right, I will see Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Uthman, Sayyidina Khalid, Sayyidina Anas. When I turn left, I will see Sayyidina Usama. I will see Sayyidina Abu Ubaidah. I see Sayyidina Hudhaifa. When I see front of me Rasulullah, who is my Imam, behind me, like, and so on. Now, what is the meaning of being with them? Meaning of being with them here, just as I said, is the imagination, is to understand that the feelings they have when they pray. The books of Sirah, the books of biographies, have explained for us that meanings. Sayyidina Rasulullah used to be and Sahaba at the masjid waiting for the prayer, you know, before Adhan. And Sayyidina Rasulullah used to say, Ya Bilal, when the time enter, Arihna biha Ya Bilal. Let us find the peace, let us find the tranquility, O Bilal. Because call for Adhan, because we want to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, sisters, don't rush when you pray. Don't rush because you have meeting or anything. Because any, whatever you're going to face, anything you're going to do, any interest for you, depend on the prayers and depend on the one whom you're praying to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The blessings and support won't come from anyone except support from Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. My beloved brothers and sisters, we have to understand that the prayers is a mi'raj, ascension of the spirits to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you feel the khushu', of course, it's not that I'm saying that we pray until we find the khushu'. And don't say also, I can't find the khushu' at all. The humbleness in the prayer, the feelings. This thing will happen. You do your job. You do your part. And Allah will do his part. If you don't have khushu' now, you will have it tomorrow. Pray jama'ah with the good people. Listen to lectures. Pray at night. In your sujood, ask Allah. In your dua, ask Allah, Ya Allah, I'm your servant. I'm blessed to be your servant. I'm honored to be your servant, created by you. My soul is under control of your power. I belongs to you. I came from you and belongs to you. I'm going to return to you. Therefore, Ya Allah, allow me to pray to you in a way it should be, to feel that you are with me and I am with you. Pray to him to say, Ya Allah, forgive my sins. Let my prayers be a true prayer, that true prayers, that it will shine in my heart, and we can see the shining of that in my behavior, and let everyone make use of it. My generosity, my humbleness, my politeness, because of the prayer, did that for you. My beloved brothers and sisters, Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj was an extraordinary miracle for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he saw all the prophets and messengers, where he was blessed and welcomed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, we are not talking about Yawm al-Qiyamah and Jannah. It's extra, it's more than that. It's higher, bigger, more greater than all of these things which we're giving to him, alayhi salat wa salam. Sayyidina Yusuf, Allah took him out from the jail to become the ruler. He became the ruler, the prime minister of Egypt. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took out Sayyidina Rasulullah from the hardship to the ease, to the opening, to the blessings, to the feelings, so that the ummah will feel the same, insha'Allah, if they do what he used to do, alayhi salat wa salam. Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given so much of opportunities and offers in his life from the non-believers. We will give you how much you want of money, will make you the richest. If you want people, they will be with you. If you want rule, will make you the king. But stop talking about your message. And he tell Abu Talib, who came with message, this message to him, and he said, my uncle, oh uncle, I will not give up till I die. Even though if they give me the sun in my right, they bring down the sun, they put in my right, and the moon in my left, I won't leave it. You see what Allah gave him, Isra al-Mi'raj? He went to place where the sun, the moon, the stars underneath his feet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Place where no one can reach, no one understand, because been Jesus given to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is something telling us who is Rasulullah, who is our teacher, who is our master, and what we should do to obey him through the message which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have sent through him, and how to pray like him, and how to perform our ibadat like we used to do. He is our excellent example. He is the blessed prophet and messenger who was given the opportunity to see what others cannot see, to touch what others cannot touch, and to step in a place that no one can stay in that place except him. Therefore, Sahaba, when they used to look to him, to his eyes, to his blessed face, lighted face, al-Munawwar, to his hands, when they got the opportunity to kiss his hand, to sit with him, looking to his feet, they know he, alayhi salatu salam, went and came back from a very extraordinary meeting with an extraordinary gifts from an extraordinary place. Brothers, sisters, it's our time now to reconnect ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The prayer, as Sayyidina Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jailani said, the prayers of the lovers, it disconnect them from the creatures and just keep them connected with the Creator. You cannot spend all your money and efforts to make people happy with you. But it's only Allah who can do that for you and for free. And He will reward you that if you pray and if you ask Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When al-Isra al-Mi'raj story comes, we read the story. It's there, available in the books of Sunnah and in the Quran, first of all. But we don't want to make it a story. We just remember it in the 27th of Rajab, Laylatul Isra al-Mi'raj. But it's an extraordinary story to give us hope. To give us hope to say that Allah's support is there for you. Allah's help when it comes to being extraordinary. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mahabba can give you this extraordinary love, that awliya Allah, they became awliya Allah. Who are they? Alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqoon. They are the believers and they are the pious. Lahum al-bushra fi al-hayat dunya wa fi al-akhira. The good news will be glad tidings for them in dunya and in akhira. See, Allah giving them all these things to awliya Allah. Whom? Who are they? Those people whom they know the meaning of being Allah's servant, subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers, sisters, we need to talk about Isra al-Mi'raj in simple way to our children, to say to them, this is our religion, this is our prophet, this is our deen, the deen of humanity, the deen of love, the deen of kindness, and the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the purest heart. In fact, that heart is a source of all purity for all mankind. And if you want yourself to be accepted, you have to have a heart which is pure. You have to have a heart which is ready for the next. There are hearts which is waiting for the giving, hearts waiting for acceptance, their heart waiting for meetings. Our heart need to be changed, the feelings need to be changed. And if that happens, we'll be blessed, inshallah. I have experienced lots of stories, unfortunately, about the heart. People who pray five times, people who fast, by the end of the day, they have cheated other people. Their prayers will keep them away from Allah. The more they pray, the more they will have distance away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is something which is cannot be accepted, brothers and sisters, and this is what they will get. Instead of getting the closeness, they will get the curse. May Allah protect us. So inshallah, we have to look after the prayers which is given to us as a trust, as an amana. Min Allah, as a result of one of the results of Al-Isra al-Mi'raj, so that we can feel it. It will take us, the prayers will take us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala each and every time we pray, each and every rak'ah, each and every tasbihah. We say subhanallah, we say alhamdulillah, we say la ilaha illallah, we say Allahu Akbar. Which with each of them, we will get the blessing of being min al-dhakirin wa al-dhakirat. My beloved brothers and sisters, don't want to take much of your time, but think of this blessed night, Al-Isra al-Mi'raj. Think of how to going to spend the nights, the blessed nights of Ramadan, inshallah, Allah barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. This is a time for us to think so that Ramadan, when it's come, inshallah, if Allah has given us the opportunity of being His worshipper in a month of Ramadan, we have to worship in an extraordinary way, and we can see the changes for us in our spiritual form and in our physical form, in our action, in our feelings. And we pray that Allah protect us from evil of seen and unseen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring the rice to us, which has been taken from us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all evil of human being and jinn, evil of seen and unseen. And may Allah keep us protected في الدنيا والآخرة. ربنا تقبل منا واقبلنا ارضنا وسامحنا بارك في أحوالنا وأقوالنا وأفعالنا واجعلنا من عبادك المتقين وارض عنا مولانا بما رضيت به عن عبادك الصالحين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلي اللهم وسلم بارك على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله خير my beloved brothers sisters I ask Allah to bless you to protect you enjoy your celebration the night of Isra al-Mi'raj with your family, with your friends, brothers and sisters. And we pray that Allah grant us opportunity also to be with all of you again in the next program. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.